My dear Frodo, you asked me once if I had told you everything there was to know about my adventures. While I can honestly say I have told you the truth, I may not have told you all of it.
In the middle of the earth, in the land of Shire, lives a brave little hobbit whom we all admire. With his long wooden pipe, fuzzy woolly toes, he lives in a hobbit hole and everybody knows him. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, he's only 3 feet tall. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, the bravest little hobbit of them all. Now hobbits are peace-loving folks, you know. They're never in a hurry and they take things slow. They don't like to travel away from home. They just like to eat and be left alone. But one day Bilbo was asked to go on a big adventure to the caves below to help some dwarves get back their gold that was stolen by a dragon in the days of old. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, only 3 feet tall. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, the bravest little hobbit of them all. Well, he fought with the goblins. He battled a troll. He riddled with Gollum. A magic ring he stole. He was chased by wolves, lost in the forest, escaped in a barrel from the Elf King's halls. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, the bravest little hobbit of them all. Home in the land of Shire, that brave little hobbit whom we all admire, just a-sitting on a treasure of silver and gold, a-puffing on his pipe in his hobbit hole. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, he's only 3 feet tall. Bilbo, Bilbo Baggins, the bravest little hobbit of them all.
Pisa, the muffin talker. This is what happens when I go to bed at 1:30-ish. No, you're not still filming this, are you?